What's up, guys? Welcome back to Polygon Academy. Tim here again. And a few of you were asking me in my from my ArtStation Challenge video series how I went about sculpting the wood that I'm using for my scene. So it's a rainy Saturday. I figured I'd sit down and show you the three techniques that I use to quickly sculpt wood in ZBrush. In this case, we're not going to be using any custom alphas or anything like that. We're literally going to be using three brushes, the trimbordersmooth, the claytubes with a square alpha, and the DamStandard Brush. Just those, it's probably going to be faster if you were to use custom alphas, but in this case, it's pretty quick using these three brushes anyways, and it gets a nice level of detail right off the bat. Finally, be sure to stay to the end of the video because I'm going to give you two tips that will save you a lot of time and help you get nicer end results, I find. So let's hop over to ZBrush and dive right in. All right, so here we are in ZBrush. I've imported a very basic like 2x4 shape from 3D Studio Max. If you look at the polyframe, it's literally just an evenly subdivided cube. Super simple. And the first brush that we're going to be using is the Trim Border Smooth Brush. And if it's not in the default brushes selection most of the time. So you can actually find it if you go to the light box, hit brushes, find trim, and it's down here in the bottom, Trim Border Smooth. So this is a nice brush for getting like hard angular cuts, I find. And I use it a lot on rocks, wood, anything that I want to get nice clean cuts and lines, and it helps avoid that really blobby look that some people get when they first start sculpting in ZBrush. So what I'm going to do is take my geometry, turn off the smooth because I want to keep these nice crisp edges. I'm going to hit divide a couple times, maybe undo that one, and then turn on smooth for the last final divide, maybe one more time. So. Right now we're sitting at about 400,000 active points or polygons or whatever it is. I'm not a ZBrush pro, so I very rarely use it and I'm trying to learn more myself. So I figured I'd hop right in and show you the techniques that I've been learning and hopefully you can get something out of it too. So with my Trim Smooth Border Brush, I'm just going to go over all of the edges and kind of rough them up a bit. And I'm going to decrease my Z intensity here so I don't destroy them too much. And reduce my brush size. And I'm gonna tilt the mesh at like about a 45 degree angle and just start going over these edges to start chipping them up and just lightly tapping on them with my tablet just to break up that hard solid edge. Just going back and forth, dinging them up a bit. And just really quickly going over each edge just to get it a little bit more of an organic shape. Adding little chips here and there. And depending on how hard you push with your tablet, it'll destroy the edge a bit more. And I'm really not spending a lot of time here. I'm just going over and adding that quick base level of wear and tear. Try not to focus on like little tiny details too early on. So getting these, if you go back and forth, you can get these nice little kind of like wood cuts. Just quickly touching on every edge. So if I zoom out, just want to look at how this is looking as a whole. Right now the details are kind of a bit small, so I want to go and add some larger forms. So like a little bit more larger damage here and there. Just so it actually reads from a distance. Some of these are nice like broken edge. It breaks up the straight lines a bit. There you go, we're getting a nice little like wavy kind of chunked up look. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to grab the clay tubes brush with a square alpha and we're going to start to add some of those like wood grain effects that wood tends to have, and especially like old aged wood, a lot of the grain's kind of peeling away and a bit more exposed. So we're going to go for a look like that. I'm going to grab the clay tubes. And it has the square alpha already. And in this step, we're just gonna start adding, check my Z intensity, just gonna start adding some like horizontal strokes to the wood. Just really loose and quick and easy here. Just how like in real life, the wood tends to, all the grain tends to flow mostly in one direction. And it looks kind of weird and ugly right now, but we're gonna fix that in a little bit. And maybe go into the edge here and just start to bust it in, like the like some 2x4s, you get that kind of like chunked up edge. Just keeping it really loose and simple right now. Maybe bust in some more here. Just building up these overlapping layers. Maybe change up your brush size a little bit. Get a little bit more different shapes. So right now it's starting to look really, really noisy. And that's generally something you kind of want to avoid, especially if you're gonna be baking this down to a normal map, because a lot of the times you can over-detail it and it starts to just look really noisy in a game engine. Next thing what we're gonna do is we're gonna use the third brush, the DamStandard, and cut into it a little bit to add some nice little grooves and chips into the wood. And I'm gonna hold Alt and just start to, actually not Alt, I'm just gonna sculpt with the default brush, some like more defined horizontal lines that kind of cut into the wood here and there. Keep the brush size small so it doesn't pinch in too much and create that pillowy look. Really hack away at this wood, because we're going to be scaling back these effects in a little bit. Get those nice like flowing grooves in the wood. Really beat up these edges here. And if I swing around, you can see it's starting to get fairly destroyed. We're going to fix that in a little bit too. Alright, so now we've got the overall look of our grain in place and the major like lines and forms. What we're going to do is we're going to clean up this noise and so we get some more of those nice angles and flat shapes back, so that when the light rolls off it in a normal map, it reads really well. So let's go back to our Trim Smooth Border Brush and flatten out some of these larger pillowy forms and get that nice chunky look back. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to rotate this plank. I've been working where it's just facing the camera on a flat axis, and that actually helps me not to concave it or make it too weirdly shaped in some other of the other sides of the mesh. So, and also by using the Trim Smooth Border when it's directly facing the camera, it'll actually shave off those details parallel to the camera. And that way you can keep like, basically like how wood is planed in real life. It's just shaved away in layers and layers and layers. And that way you're not getting strange angles cut into it and then you're trying to have to go back and fix those later. So with this brush, I'm just gonna lightly start to go over it in different areas here. And you can see it starts to flatten out some of the details. Actually, my intensity is pretty high, so I'm gonna drag that down. Maybe undo a little bit. Yeah, I just start to go over these forms and flatten, it kind of shaves them off and brings them back down. And the harder you push up, the flatter it'll go. But you just go over it, touching it here and there. And it scales back some of that noise. Starts to look like a nice piece of aged old wood. It's all beaten up with some nice flowing lines and detail here and there. And where was it? It was starting to get really concaved and beat up on this edge. So what I'm gonna do, zoom in. If you hold Alt with the Trim Smooth Border, it actually brings it back up towards the camera instead of planing it away. So what I'll do is I'll hold Alt on this top edge and start to bring it back up. And shave it off a little bit where it's getting a little too popped out. Decrease my brush size, and on in this edge here, I'm gonna start to flatten it, that second layer back a little bit too. So just start hitting these edges. And I'm actually gonna switch to the square alpha on my brush, and that keeps the edges even harder and more like chunky and defined. So it helps avoid that blobby, noisy look. Zoom out. You don't want to zoom in too much on especially on a small piece of wood like this, because you can get really lost in the details and then it starts to become really muddy. So I always want to work and sculpt about how like roughly the size is going to be seen on screen or in game. And that way you know the amount of detail you actually have to put into it. just going over, flattening out some more of these areas. Maybe damage these edges up a little bit more, make it a little bit more extreme in some areas. And same for this edge here. Start to bring it with Alt, bring it back up to the same level to get that nice crisp broken edge. And then on the second layer, bring it back down and chunk it out. Just really chunking it in, destroying it up. Once you start to get a few like undulations in the wood, if you actually hit those on the side with the trim smooth border, it kind of angles them rather than being flat to the camera. It takes that initial, like say 45 or 20 degree angle of that bulge, and it'll start to slice it the entire stroke of the brush in that direction. So you can start to get little angular cuts in the wood. As you can see, I did right here, just bringing that in. Bring that in. And so we're starting to lose some of that grain detail. So I'm just gonna go back to the DamStandard brush, which is B, D, and S is the default hotkey for that. And just go over it again, cutting in some more defined lines. Nice swoops, give it that organic feel. And if I look from the side, it's starting to concave a little bit. So back to my smooth border trim brush and just go over it again. This time I might hold Alt to bring some of it back up towards the camera so it's not concaving too much. And just hit those shapes a bit more, bring this back up. There we go. Starting to look exactly the result I would want. I'd probably spend a bit more time on this, really chunking in these end tips here to get some nice, really readable, clean details. But that's literally my exact process I used to build the wood trims in my scene. So it's just three brushes. Go with the large, build from the large forms down to the small details, just like when I'm building my environments. Ding up those major edges first, sculpt in the wood grain, add some cuts with the DamStandard brush, and then just go over it with the trim border smooth brush again, or trim smooth border, sorry, and go over and just start to remove some of the noise on the overall model. And yeah, you'll be in good shape for wood. As you can see, I'm only sculpting this piece of wood at about 400,000 polys, which is, a lot of people tend to crank up the subdivision level to like 6 million in the beginning because they think they need to add a ton of detail. But in reality, if I zoom out, all the details are super readable on the average size that it would be on screen. So it's not gonna take up a ton of extra memory when I bring it for baking, or it's gonna, you know, it's a lot of unnecessary detail sometimes that people add. Because when I bake this down to a 1024 or 2048 normal map on with some other planks, you're really not gonna notice that fine micro grain detail. And in which case, what I would do is, if I want it to be a bit more crisp, is I would create these large to medium forms in ZBrush. And then when I texture it in Substance Painter, it's gonna add more noise and grain on top of that anyways. And then if I wanna really get that final level of detail inside Unreal, I'll add a tiling detail normal wrap of wood grain over top of that. And that way I can keep it really crisp. But I really want my sculpt to have these large readable forms. And that way everything doesn't turn too noisy, which is a big problem with a lot of beginner ZBrush work, is you just add too much detail, too much noise, and try and like, oh, I have a million polygons, I need to add all this detail. And it just starts to get really noisy. But by keeping these forms on this mesh larger to medium size, it actually gives Substance Painter, when I use smart materials on top of the wood, something to play off of. And that way I get a nice result without wasting a ton of extra time sculpting tiny little details that are not even needed or will never be seen in game. And yeah, so that would be my final two tips, is don't overwork your work with too much detail, and then layer on detail inside the game engine or Substance Painter later on. And that way you're not wasting a ton of time on your sculpts, and you're quickly using tools to save time and get the same decent result as if you spent 6 hours sculpting every single little piece of grain of the wood. So there you go. I hope you guys enjoyed this. It's my process that I'm using. There's a ton of other ways to sculpt wood. You can use alpha sheets to quickly add all this detail. But in this case, I find it quicker to just switch between two or three brushes, stylize my result a little bit, and then get into Substance Painter, add those textures, add those extra details, and then get it in game as soon as possible, and then tweak from there. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that mini tutorial. If you did, leave a comment below letting me know, and smash that subscribe button, because I got a ton more content on the ArtStation challenge coming up soon. And as always, see you in the next video.